Hey. Hey guys, it's a consistent queen back with another video because I mean you guys know we are consistent. So this video is not like any other that I've ever done, as you guys can probably tell from the title. This is my very first wig installation slash wig review video, and the wig that I'll be installing and reviewing is by Superbwigs. So let me give you guys the name of this wig. It is quite a mouthful. It is the Wesley Swiss lace wig, pre-plucked hide lace, hide knots bob lace wig. So this one is 14 inches. It is Brazilian hair. It is 150% density. It has a 6-inch lace. So the parting is quite, like, you can do a lot with the front. You can do a lot with the parting. And the price for this wig is $170. I'm not quite sure how much that is in rand, but you guys can do the conversion. So if you want to see how I slayed this wig and how I became such a mujer, watch the rest of this video. Now before I talk too much, watch me do the most. Let us get into the video. What I like to have underneath my wigs is simple cornrows, basically scondro, because you know I want my wig to lay flat on my head. I don't want any bumps in the road. I don't want anything that like jump pieces that I'm wearing a wig. Get what I'm saying? So this is the box that the wig came in. See, it says Superbwigs, and I think this is like really, really cute. If you want, you can use the box to like store other stuff because it is quite, it's quite a big box. And alright, so it slides open. Then what you get inside the box is it comes with wig caps. So there's two of them in this one packet if you want to use the wig cap method and all of that. And this is one size fits all. And then we have these adjustable elastic bands. You guys are going to see what they're used for a bit later. And this is the wig. The wig. I don't know why I did that. Okay. So the wig comes inside this net. So I just took it out of the net. This is the wig, guys. These are the straps that I was telling you about. So you can use it to like adjust the size of your wig. So yeah, which is pretty convenient because you know not all of us have the same cap size, you know what I'm saying? So you can use it to make sure that like your wig sits nicely on you specifically. And then there's plenty more which allows for like more customization, you know what I mean? Look at this guys. We're for art delays. Oh guys, so I'm gonna be comparing this Swiss lace to the normal one. This is the normal one. Y'all can see the difference, right? You couldn't see the lace on that one as much as you can on this one. Even when I like hold it against, I mean you guys can like see it. So what I'm gonna do for you guys is I have my little spritzer here. Now I'm just gonna, and then see, you can still see the lace, right? Y'all can see the lace. Now let's compare it to the Swiss lace. This is just for demonstration purposes only because I don't want you guys to be like confused, because even me, I was confused just the other day, just the other moment I was also confused, but like I don't want y'all to be confused. Alright. Oh, let me just move the hair there because I don't want to like make my hair wet because you know I'm gonna be installing it. Okay, so then this is the lace with this one. So let me just spritz there. I spritzed, made it wet and stuff. And then there we go. This one just like guys, the lace was already non-existent and I feel like it just disappeared even more, you get what I'm saying? So now it's time for us to install the wig. Guys, this is me with the wig on. As you guys can see, I haven't really done much, I just threw it on. Oh, and I also adjusted the elastic band so that it fits nicely on my head. I want it to be firm but not tight, guys, because like, if you have a tight wig, chances are, babes, dear beloved, you are going to get a headache. And imagine now you are slaying, you have a headache. No, man, don't do that to yourself, don't do that to yourself. So now it's time to, oh wait, oh guys, are y'all seeing this? Oh, look at this, guys, this is like, I threw it on like I haven't even done anything. Please look at this, look at this, look at this. Wait, this is actually the perfect time to also compare it to the normal lace, guys. Let me just compare the lace real quick. Guys, please tell me you see the difference. Please tell me you see the difference. If you see the difference, please just comment down below. Let me know that I'm not dizzy. Because, guys, I mean, y'all saw what I saw too, right? Y'all saw what I saw too. Anyways, I was just saying, guys, like, this is pretty impressive. And I really like how it just blends, guys. It blends. And also, the Swiss lace is suitable for any complexion. So you don't have to be light. You don't have to be dark. You don't have to be pink, orange, purple. Like, come as you are, babes. The Swiss lace is for you. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to be cutting the lace. So when it comes to the lace, I like to cut it up into four sections. So I have 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then now I'm just going to, like, cut the lace. So I usually want to like do this off camera because this is such a tedious task. And guys, like, if you make mistakes, please don't make a mistake here. Please, please don't let this be the place where you make a mistake. So let me cut my lace. So this is me after just cutting my lace. Yeah, guys, as you can see, we've made progress. Whoop. So when I cut my lace, it is a bit messy because I mean, like, I can't cut the lace in a straight line because my hairline is also not a straight line, you get what I'm saying? So the goal is to cut the lace according to your hairline. So like, ideally you should be like putting it on your head and then cutting like that, so you see that you get all the curves right, everything right, you get what I'm saying? So now it is time for me to just, like, you know, I like to do my wigs on because, hey guys, next thing you're walking, next thing someone is snatching your wig, yo guys, me, I would just, like, I would just be deceased, I would just die. But then because of the nature of the lace, you don't really have to do much to melt the lace, as many of you guys may have, you know, figured out. Guys, now for me personally, I like to use Got To Be Glue because, I mean, as far as I'm concerned, it's like pretty great. And because sometimes I have a thing of like, I don't want to touch things with my hands, I have this little brush. So it's also like one up from the normal old toothbrush that we be using sometimes. Oh, and guys, what I like about Got To Be Glue is that, like, it's not sticky, it's not flaky, it's just, and yo guys, it'll glue that thing down. Woo! Guys, when you use Got To Be Glue, like, best believe your wig is not going anywhere. It's not going anywhere. It is not going anywhere. So in Got To Be Glue, I trust. Now, what I am gonna do is, okay, so I put the glue on my brush, like. So, okay, I put a little bit too much, but then, like, oop. So, I'm just gonna put the glue here. So, I'm putting this on nice and tight. so that my baby hairs can lay. Okay guys, so now it's time to take this off. Y'all see what I did there? Y'all see what I be doing? Y'all see what I did? Ooh, cutie pie, cutie pie. So like, I didn't want to overdo it with my baby hairs because, guys, just because it looks nice on camera and just because it looks nice on other people doesn't mean it will necessarily look nice on you. And personally, I don't prefer, like, you know, too much going on. And yeah guys, yo, this thing is just, it's free parting. Like, there's so much space that you can work with here and fries more than with a normal lace wig. So I'm always gonna keep going back to this one because it's a convenient comparison versus here where like there's like already a parting there, and like whatever you do, even when you use mousse, the parting that they had is still gonna open. So it's like, it's a bit tricky, tricky, rick, you know what I'm saying? So now I'm just gonna like straighten this wig just a bit, you know, to also like neaten it up, style it a bit. Let's do that. So I like to use a hot brush when I am done with my edges and everything because, you know, I just wanna like clean up my act a bit. You could use a straightener. The thing is, yeah, I know, man, guys, straightening is like a lot of hard work, and I feel like this is just such a cheat sheet. So if there's a cheat sheet, then like why not use it, you know what I'm saying, you know? And you can see that it is working quite well. Compare this side to this side. Guys, can we please also talk about like how silky this hair is? Oh guys, this is a convo we definitely need to have because guys, I'm just so amazed by this hair. Okay, guys, so now that I've straightened it to the point that I want it to be, it's time to decide what I want. So it came with a parting there, but then like I'm already one for parting. So I'm just gonna like just like comb it back. I just want like a straight thing going back, you get what I'm saying? I feel like that is very cute. Just that. Ooh, guys! No way, guys. Is this me? Is this I? Is this Dinelle, consistent queen, Dube? I think not. I think not. Guys, I feel like I pulled a number here. Like, I really, really feel like I did something. Like, what lace? What lace? What lace? Where is the lace? Where is the lace? Guys, sickening! Superbwigs was not playing when they said undetectable knots. I mean, they were serious. So anyways, guys, before I just like, you know, go off about this hair because I'm quite impressed, let me bring this video to an end. Guys, thank you so much for watching. If you want the website, I'm obviously going to put it there in the description box. And any info that I think y'all might want to know will definitely be in the description box. So until next time, bye.